I was just at DJI's event, and now I'm lost. They introduced Phantom 4 Pro and Inspire 2, and they all look fantastic. These people don't go to sleep. They're constantly introducing new products. The event took place in Warner Bros. Lot in Los Angeles, California. Michael Perry took the stage and said,
Phantom 4 Pro offers professional imaging and creative controls in a ready-to-fly package.
Yes, Phantom 4 Pro, which has a 20 megapixel camera that has 1-inch CMOS image sensor, is a huge upgrade from Phantom 4's 12 megapixel camera and 1 over 2.3-inch sensor. In case you're wondering, the sensor is the one in Sony RX100 Mark IV. This camera can shoot 4K, and when I say 4K, I mean 4096 to 2160 at 60 frames at a bitrate of 100 megabits per second. Okay, pause. Let that sink in for a while. 4K, 60 frames per second at 100 megabits per second. Okay, let's move on. It has a mechanical shutter, so you can say bye-bye to rolling shutter effect. Also, DJI added vision sensor at the rear and infrared sensors on the sides of the Phantom 4 Pro. It can detect obstacles that are 98 feet in front. You can fly at 31 miles per hour, which is 50 kilometers per hour, with full obstacle avoidance protection. You really have to be the ultimate Mr. Magoo to crash this drone. Thanks to its new higher capacity battery, the battery life now is 30 minutes. And the range is 4.3 miles, which is 7 kilometers, and now it is as same as Mavic. If you don't want to use your phone or your tablet on the remote, now there's an option to get Phantom 4 Pro with built-in 1000 nit 1080p 5.5 inch screen. The intelligent flight system is updated as well. There's a new feature called Draw. You just draw the way you like the drone to fly, and it does. Thanks to its new sensors, it can fly this backwards too. Also, Phantom 4 has a new tap fly feature where you can make the drone fly forwards, backwards, or free, where you can make the camera look anywhere you like. It has an upgraded return to home function where it can use the route it flew and find a safe way back to home point. And the great gesture mode from Mavic is now in Phantom 4 Pro. And then there's the monster, the drone of the drones, Inspire 2. To explain how great Inspire 2 is, they shot a movie right in front of our eyes and they made it look ridiculously simple.
Pictures up, all talent to one, please, all talent to one.
Brothers.
I'm about to introduce the DJI Inspire 2. Wow.
Inspire 2 can fly up to 67 miles per hour, which is 108 kilometers per hour, and it has a 27-minute flight time. You can mount the new X4S or X5S cameras on it, and it can shoot 5.2K video at 30 frames per second. If they had handheld mics, I think this is where they should have dropped it and walked off the stage. Inspire 2 has upwards infrared sensors for better indoor flying, obstacle avoidance, terrain detection, and a dedicated camera for the pilot. DJI also announced their new monitor called Crystal Sky, or as I like to call it, Crystalsky, which has less latency than regular mobile devices. And it comes in two sizes, 5.5 inch and 7.85 inch. After the announcements were done, we picked up our jaws from the ground, and then we watched a short movie shot entirely on Inspire 2. And there you have it, everything about the DJI event. I will be reviewing these products as soon as I can get my hands on one of them. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode, and I hope you enjoyed it. Please hit that subscribe button. I must have a subscribe button somewhere here on the screen. Hit that subscribe button and join the world domination. And until I see you next time, take really good care of yourselves. And hoşça kalın. What's up, what's up?